Let's try a little 14 days in Georgia. That's in C.
It starts
on
C.
It starts on C, too, yeah.
That's good.
Kansas City playing with bluegrass bands. His style fit that way of playing, you know, because that's kind of a bluegrassy tune. But that's actually an old Tommy Jackson tune. Has anybody heard of Tommy Jackson? You know, he's put out a lot of records in the 50s, and a lot of old-time fiddlers were influenced heavily by him. You know, they liked the tunes were played really good, and they were really nice arrangements. And so that's a Tommy Jackson tune here. Why don't we play another Tommy Jackson tune? Let's see if I can think of it here. Acorn Hill Breakdown, in D, yeah. This is another tune a mid-Missouri fiddler played, but it's also turned out later it was Tommy Jackson tune, so, but I like it a lot. It's called Acorn Hill Breakdown. Thank you. Tony Jackson tune there. As you can tell, these tunes, I like kind of notey tunes, you know, where the fiddle does kind of drives the rhythm, sometimes driving the rhythm more with the kind of left-hand phrasing than you are with the bow phrasing. So, but that's a very nice little tune there. Well, we were fooling around earlier with an Arthur Smith tune, which is a rag called Smith's Rag. And you commented that the first and second parts sound exactly alike, and they pretty much do. So, and everybody know who Arthur Smith was, one of the big fiddlers in the early days of recorded fiddle music from Tennessee. This is one of his tunes, Smith's Rag, and the thing I like about it, I kind of play a Kenny Baker version, which has a third part in C, so it makes it a little more interesting, because otherwise, as you'll see as we play it, the first and second part are kind of similar. So let's see. So it's G G C, yeah. And maybe the C part's twice, but I think based on what you were telling me. But don't worry about that.
Right.
You'll come to it, you know. All right. I have to be careful because this tune starts up just like Dill Pickle Rag, and I'll